Other people have been looking at bioreactors throughout the Midwest, I guess, for about seven to 10 years. They've started to look at bioreactors as a practice to treat the tile water and the nitrates in the tile water. Now we have 5 bioreactors in to date. Our oldest bioreactor in Greene County actually has 2 years of data as of this August. And what we've seen so far from that bioreactor is after 1 year, we saw about a 38% reduction in nitrate load for the entire year. So that's some very positive early signs from this bioreactor demonstration project. We're also learning that landowners are very interested in this as a practice, and one, this practice can be implemented with other best management practices such as comprehensive nutrient management plans. We feel that the bioreactors can be a very effective tool. Right now, bioreactors are actually on the interim standard through EQIP, so they can get a cost share of up to $4,000 approximately to implement a bioreactor, and that covers about 50% of a typical bioreactor installation for the landowner.
We got interested in the Boone River watershed primarily through Iowa Soybean Association because they were the ones that were for making this Boone River watershed happen. We felt we had a pretty good spot to do one, and we got that opportunity to have it on our farm, and it's been interesting to see how it's going, and I think everybody's pretty excited about it. We're all interested in taking care of the Boone River watershed, and I intend to put in a few more on my own of the bioreactors just because it cuts down the nitrogen availability in the water as well as the phosphate, which is important.
The interesting thing about bioreactors is there's not an actual direct benefit to that producer other than knowing that they're doing something to improve the water quality that's coming out their land. All the benefits from the bioreactor are actually seen downstream